also. Okay? Even in him, a realized person will see that I amness. Okay? Samadarshinaha, he sees them equally. Samadarshinaha means he sees them equally. But he doesn't say he treats them equally. For you, for that you have to understand. Sri Ramana, Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa said, there is a God in man, the God in dog, and God in tiger. But for the God in tiger, do namaskar from a distance. So, seeing is one thing, treating is another thing. Right? Are you clear? Enemy is there, you see God in him. But treat enemy as an enemy. Okay? If you say, no, you are my enemy, I am doing namaskar to you, it will kill you. That's not the purpose. Right? So when you see God in everybody, there will be love in you. Okay? There's no agitation, but you will do right action. Sri Krishna Paramatma, when he killed so many, he oversaw the killing of 50 lakh people in Mahabharata war. Okay? He didn't have a single bit of agitation. No hatred. Okay? When doctor cuts a cancer, okay? Doctor doesn't hate that cancer. He's just doing the job. So when you see the human, when you see the divinity in everybody, you have a love, compassion, but right action. Are we clear? Any doubts? So no, I'm seeing God in you, okay, come Baba, you go and do namaskar to tiger. Then Brahma Arpanam Brahma. You become one with the tiger god. But is that what you want? Right?
So Gora Kumara took it a bit far.
No. See, these are all told as an example. Okay? Not really. Because people have to communicate this thing. Okay? So, this is not a literal sense. There are many incidents are told as an example for common men to understand.
Rather misunderstand.
Right? There is a story in the life of Kanakadas also. Swamiji's Guruji was there. Guruji knows that Kanakadasa sees God every day. He says, assuming God also. So then, Naivedya time we'll get it. God will come. God has promised. So Naivedya time, they're sitting puja. Suddenly one snake comes and everybody runs away. Then God came in the form of snake. The next day, again you'd show me God. A dog came and eat prasad and everybody started chasing. So God came in the form of dog. Like that, these are told as more of a what I'm saying is to make people understand. Don't have to take a very literal sense, but once you understand the essence of what it is, you understand. Are you clear? Is it simple?
Yes.
This is the realization of God. If you are thinking that realization of God is something else, you're not understood. God is real. I am. Without that feeling of alienness, if you take it out, there's no, you're not there. Dead. Again and again, go back to that I am, stay there. That is Saguna Brahma. Are you clear? Is it complex? So the moment more and more you see, please understand, the more and more you see, you'll see effect. You start feeling oneness. The plants, animals, everywhere you start feeling oneness. Right now, if you have fear, because you are seeing separation. If you are emotionally disturbed, because you are seeing separation. The moment you see oneness, that's love. That's called bhakti. Bhakti is not what you do prayer. Bhakti is not what you do bhajan. Bhakti is oneness which you feel when you are in I amness, when you are God.
Recently, there was a video in Madurai, in one of the Narasimhaswamy temples. Nice, brilliant, golden colored cobra climbed, and it stood there, and everybody, instead of getting scared, they accepted it as God and did puja, they showed Mangalati, everything they did.
Nice. Poor fellow was scared of everybody, so even move.
No, I think it was feeling the vibration.
Yeah.
Right. So are we clear? We can go further. So if you are feeling oneness with existence, that means you are with God. If you are feeling separation, then you are individual. The more you feel stay in I amness, the more you start feeling oneness with God. What sadhana is required to feel, for doing this? Tell me. What sadhana will have to do, you do to realize God? How can you feel oneness? You are oneness. Feel that, to feel that oneness, why do you need sadhana?
Practice that oneness.
Is it a practice? Practice means effort is required. Okay, to go back to oneness, there is no practice also. Practice means there is an effort involved.
Attention.
At this stage where we are, to go to that stage, some practice, maybe.
Where you are now? Are you alive?
Yes.
So pay attention to the awareness. Finish. That's not a sadhana.
Paying attention.
Paying attention is not a sadhana. See, sadhana means effort is involved. Sadhana involves a siddhi. Okay? A practice involves some steps and siddhi. Shifting the attention is not a sadhana. Okay? It's not called effort. The word sadhana is wrongly understood. For example, look at the TV. Okay? It's natural. Look at yourself. Attention is shifted, that's all. It's not effort. Shifting attention is not effort. Effort means there's a strain. And effort involves a siddhi, result. The moment you shift your attention to aliveness, there's already you're with God. There's no gap. No, I'll pay attention to my aliveness and after 10 hours I'll experience God. No. The moment you pay attention to aliveness, you are already with God. The God is life. That's called Saguna Brahma. Is it clear to everybody? Everybody is not clear? Practice this. This is called Sahaja Samadhi.
Do practice.
I mean, I have to want to. I got it. Okay, go back again and again to I amness. Right? Pay your attention to I amness. The moment you do that, you start feeling the oneness in the universe.
So whenever the attention goes to the world, you get it back to I amness.
Yeah, not doing office work, okay? Yes, when your boss comes, definitely do it. Shift your attention to I amness. Then stress will come down. So that is difficult?
No, but just as you said, when you are doing office work. So in that context, how would you maintain that?
Already I have told you how to make a tea for what?
Attention.
Tea ceremony, I have told you. You see?
Yeah.
How did that Japanese lady makes a tea? The video you didn't watch?
No.
You didn't watch?
No, you didn't.
I didn't do that for this?
No.
No. Some
previous
people.
Previous classes.
Okay.
Junior classes.
Okay. So, fine. So, as long, whenever you are in attention, when you pay attention, watch it. Okay, what she is doing, Sudha?
Supposed to be making tea.
So what she is really making? Actually, tea making, she is making into a meditation. Any action, you cannot convert into a meditation. Provided your attention is fully on the action. Okay? So you don't allow the mind, thoughts to roam around. So when you are, let's say you are doing tea, pay fully attention to tea, all aspects of tea, the touch, smell, sound, taste, then the mind doesn't come into picture. Then you are not allowing the society child to play mischief. Then who are there now?
Divine child.
Only divine child and human child is there. The society child is not allowed to come into picture. So provided you have to use everything, the touch, the smell, taste, sound. So when you are interacting with the world, drop the society child, human child and divine child need to work completely together. That's all. Then what will happen? The society child will lose its strength. Okay? For example, right now you are sitting, right? Just pay attention to the way you are sitting. Where your back is touching the chair. Okay, where you are sitting, become aware of the human child. Okay, society child is gone.
Suddenly
is gone, right? Right? So simple. While doing work, pay attention to work fully. Okay? If you are not paying attention to work fully, for means every aspect of work you give complete. Like for example, in early days, they used to do rangoli, right? Do you do rangoli? Do you? So when you are doing rangoli, where is the mind? So rangoli is, entire attention is there on the rangoli. So human child and divine child is there. The society child is gone. Okay. The color combination, the touch, pattern. So now the society child. The earlier our people designed many things to chase away the society child. Okay? Puja you do. So while doing puja, there are five elements, right? light, which is sight, then agarbati, which is smell, okay, then naivedyam, which is smell and taste, okay, the flowers, okay. So your entire attention is on puja. Does it stay? Sweet
question.
What?
It's a big question.
No, this is not a big question. You don't do me here to stay. You didn't understand the purpose of puja.
No.
The purpose of puja is for you to give entire attention to work. It's not about God. The moment you give entire attention to God, God only is there.
No.
The human, the society child is gone. So you don't get God because of puja. God is puja. How? When you give complete attention, the society child is gone. Human child is divine child is there. The action is happening through human child. The divine child is overseeing it. The God alone is there. Now we think that by doing puja, we'll get some benefit from God. Or we are communicating with God. No. Puja is God. That's why Basavanna said, work is worship. Okay? So what we are doing is we are thinking that by doing puja something will happen. That's why your mind is somewhere. No. The puja is God. Brahmarpanam Brahmahavihi Brahmagno Brahmanavutam Brahmaivatena Gantavyam Brahmakarma Samadhina. Brahmarpanam is Yadna. Everything what you do in Yadna is God. But your concept of God is something else. That's the problem. The God is there when the society child is not there. Simple. Society change is not there when your attention is fully on the work you are doing. As simple as that. Is it complicated?
No.
Right? Do anywhere work. Even fight a war. That's what Krishna told Arjuna. Fight a war. But yoga, yogastha kuru karmani. Fight a war, yes, yoga. That means, pay full attention to the war. Don't worry about the result. See, the whole idea is what troubles you is not human child. What troubles you is not divine child. What troubles you is society child. Okay? Society child can be kept away only when you are completely in the present moment. Is it clear at all? Anybody has a doubt? She is not making tea. She is making meditation using tea. Okay? So that's what you are supposed to do while doing rangoli. That's what you are supposed to do while doing puja. That's what you are supposed to do while cooking. That's what you're supposed to do while making, preparing a cup of coffee. Do you do? Huh? Every moment you can bring God into your life. Are you bringing God or dog? The society child is the dog. Keeps barking. Then is it complicated? We taught, Indians taught Japanese this technique. That's called Zen, means meditation. Zen was Dhyana in India. Dhyana went to Japan and became like that. They have incorporated in every aspect of their life. Now tell me one aspect of your life you have incorporated meditation in your life, tell me. Tell me one, be sincere and tell me where I am meditative while doing this. And you call yourself as Indians. Only for...
Sitting
with Vajrasana. Vajrasana also, right? Vajrasana is very difficult for us, no?
Other than Indians.
This is what India. Karma Yoga. That's called Karma Yoga. Complete action done with the total attention is called Karma Yoga. Simple. And that is a divine offering. That's God operating through the body-mind complex. Every minute of your life you can convert into meditation. Simple. Huh? Yes or no? Why do you need extra time for anything? I mean, I need some time for sadhana, I do need some time for puja. Every aspect of your life you can convert into puja. Every aspect of your life you can convert into meditation. And that's what is called sannyasa. You are thinking the sannyasa means putting a dress and growing a beard. And most of you are women, you can't even grow a beard also. Why this complication? Why this confusion? No, chanting God's name is one puja. Okay. Making a cup of coffee is also puja. Making a cup of food also is puja. Provided your attention is completely on that. provided you keep the society child out. That's all is puja. Yes.
Does that mean that relevant thoughts to that task can...
No, no, that I'll take up. When you are doing work, thoughts will not be there. I'll find out. Right? Even thoughts will not be there. To start, there is thought. But during work, there will be no thought. How is that I'll find? Right? Are you clear? See, please understand, this spirituality is nothing complex. It's common sense. It's down to earth.
What if several things are claiming your attention when you are doing something?
See, you can give attention only one at a time. You may be multitasking. Mm-hmm. Multitasking means you know many tasks at a time. Multitasking means each task you will do, give some attention and go to the next task. Mm-hmm. You cannot give attention to two things at a time.
No, that is where it gets spoiled.
No. Even when you do that, when you do, for example, do some multitasking, you will always give attention to one and come back. Mm-hmm. Give to attention 100% attention to one. Go to next attention of 100%. Don't split the attention. Switching the attention is causing problem. That's why karmanye vadikaraste ma phaleshu kadachana. While doing work, focus on the action. Don't even think of result because their attention is switching. While doing puja, then you'll say, oh God, when will you come to my house? All those things already has gone to result. The puja is God. The bhajan is God. Please understand, very simple, when the society child is not there, you are with God. How do you keep the society child out? Pay attention to what you are doing. Finished, over, matter is over. Ashwini, anything complicated? No. Huh? You don't know. What you don't know?
Let's say while planning, let's talk of intellectual things.
Let's say
physical things is okay, you can concentrate on something for some time, like what you do. But we have to plan something. That is also a job.
Correct.
It's a mental activity.
Plan perfectly. See, there are two types of planning. One is planning for activity. Okay, that's called planning. There's a psychological planning. Okay? There's a physical planning. For example, physical planning is, my children have to go to next year, the second standard, which is the good school. So when I have to apply, this is a physical planning. Okay? So you apply, there are steps involved, you plan for that. So what? There's a psychological planning. Okay? What will happen to the children who go to school? Will they study well? You know, what will happen? See the neighbor's child, you are bringing in
society child.
A planning involves human child and divine child, over. The society child is a demon which comes into picture. It causes stress. What will happen if it doesn't work out? Okay. What will happen when the child doesn't get admission? Fine. What will happen to your child doesn't get admission? Valid question. The question you have to ask immediately is, what can I do now? Doing requires a human child. Okay? Powered by divine child. So if you are not able to do anything today, can I do something tomorrow? Write it. That's a part of that. But there are many things which are not, questions will come, where there is no answer. Irrelevant questions, irrelevant confusions, they are a society child. Being in the present moment doesn't mean not planning. Do planning well. But take into action what is possible, what is not possible. Do a planning. But
information not be available.
Then make assumptions. Right? Plan well. Then when the assumptions verified, you correct the plan. Okay? But what we do is, we don't do planning. We do psychological planning. You, what to do? Okay, what if my child doesn't get admission? They are different. Psychological planning is done by the society child, physical planning by the divine and human child. All atoms saying is, now with this three child concept, you understand where the society child is coming in interfering. Keep it aside. Completely focus on the action, that becomes karma yoga. Karma yoga is God.
Any question?
Yes.
This society child also sometimes will help to the proper planning, right?
See, the society child, you can take the input.
Yeah.
Okay. But what happens is it takes over the planning.
Yeah.
Initially, it will help you. Okay. What will happen? Your child doesn't get a good mark.
Keep a plan B.
But then the society child immediately take over. I will take care of you. See, don't worry. Okay? Yeah, the whole world is like this only. Don't worry. This is full of problems only. Okay? You cannot do it in the present moment. It will take over. Right? Finally, they end up with you. Then you will also have to start doing some psychological planning for that person.
I know.
So, chain reaction will set in.
So, any questions?
So, the society child is always a negative one.
No, society child, it's also a good role only.
Yeah, she pointed out that it
society child, job is society child, is it's always thinks input from the society. Okay? And always thinks of the past or future. You have to just take input required and focus on what is required. Don't get dragged by that guy. It'll take you for a ride.
So you're asking to use the information.
Yeah.
And this society child, when you speak of, it is basically the belief systems, the conditioning.
Everything.
Whatever is accumulated.
Everything. You can take it as one of the inputs. Okay, now you have given the input. Let me do my work. Focus.
To be carried away with that.
It'll take you. In no time, it'll take you.
What? Belief systems are very deeply...
We'll kill all those, don't worry.
All
those belief systems will go. When who am I? Every belief system will collapse.
Psychological hijacking.
It'll do it. Right? Ashwini, any questions? Do perfect planning. See, yoga, karma, shakosharam, perfection in action is yoga. But what carries you away from the yoga is that the psychological child or that the society child. It creates a lot of scenarios. Some of the scenarios are valid. You take the input into action. But don't get carried away by that way. Anybody has a question? Madam, clear?
So, Guruji, thoughts come about the future, like when
we are
planning. So, it's okay, but we accept that it's the society.
No. See, I am saying, please understand. Thoughts we should not suppress. Thought is an input. But you have to ask the question, what is the action I have to take? The divine child, human child is action oriented. The society child is
thought oriented.
It create you. So, now, yeah, society child says, okay. Today the society is so much of competition, my child may not get a seat. That's input, valid input. Immediately, what is the action I have required? What is the action required for you? Let me ask. No. What is the action required for you? From this case. Either you can say, let me give a tuition to the child. Or let me say, okay, there are three more schools, I'll try there. Right? But the society child will keep on creating a web. Okay? Come out of that. Take that input. The key is convert everything into action. Finished. Actionable. The society child will keep quiet. Right? The society child will be always troubling you if you get into thought web. Come, take the thought, but convert into action. Actionable. The moment you get convert into actionable, society child will keep quiet. ಎಲ್ರಿಗೂ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ತೇನಪ್ಪ ಮೇಡಮ್ ಏನು ಡೌಟ್ ಇದೆಯಾ
ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಈಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅಟ್ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಮೈ ಕೇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಇಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಟ್ರಿಗರ್
ಅನದರ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್
ದಟ್ ಟ್ರಿಗರಿಂಗ್
ನೋ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಬಿ ಆಕ್ಷನ್ ಓರಿಯೆಂಟೆಡ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಲೆಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಟ್ರಿಗರ್ ಸೊ ದಿ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಸೇ ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಆಕ್ಷನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಕ್ಷನ್ The moment you ask for action, the triggering will stop. We can be thought-oriented, or we can...
Okay, so what is the action to be taken?
Yes.
You decide this action will take. But then that decision of taking that action, again will take another trigger, another question.
That's
whether that will happen or not.
No, that's something. Another question also, the life you make it action-oriented, not thought-oriented. Another thought, let it come. Then you ask the question, what is the action I have to take?
Okay. Immediately ask. Okay.
See, please understand, karmanne vadikaraste mahapareshu kadachana. Shri Krishna taught only action. Okay? He said, convert everything what you are happening in life to into action. Immediately you are in the present moment, immediately you are with God. Convert everything to karma yoga. Action is always not hypothesis actually. Action has to be converted physically. You may decide that I will perform this action after 1 week. That's okay. Not today. But the moment you make everything into action oriented, the society generally become quiet. Right now what's happening is, you are not being action oriented, you are following this chain. It will take you...
Yeah, it is in that loop. Or...
It will take you a loop. Action. Action. Or you say, no, I don't want decision, I will be in silent also. That's also okay. That's also action.
But is that right approach? Keeping silence at that moment?
No, I am saying. Keeping silent sometimes may be also an action.
Okay.
Depending on situation. Right? For example, I'm just giving hypothesis, okay? Some terrorist is pointing a gun at your head. Okay? Then keeping silent may be an action. Maybe that will increase the possibility of your life. So, don't say that not doing action also is an action. But then you'd say, well thought out. Convert everything into action in your life. That's all is God. Because the moment you convert everything into action, only God, action requires only two things. Human child and divine child. Society child is gone, sideways. Full attention to action. Yeah, madam. So next. Okay. So is this clear to all of you? I am that. Go back to I am. Then slowly become aware that there is aliveness in your body. Then you are moving to I. I am aware that there is aliveness in my body. Then you move to I. If you say I am aware, I am aliveness is there in my body, this is called God, Saguna Brahma. I am aware that this aliveness is me, then you are going to Nirguna Brahma, Parabrahma. Right? Are we clear? Let's do it. So that's it, there's two steps, right? There is world and I am body and everything is there. I am that, which is I am that I am. Soham. You go to first step, which is go to Saguna Brahma. Okay? Then you go to Nirguna Brahma. I am I. Who am I? I mean awareness. Ramana Maharshi, when he says who am I, he is saying go here and go here. Vani? Kathy, any clear and right? Huh? Vani?
Is it akin to transcendental meditation?
See, transcendental meditation is not real meditation. Okay? So there he gives a mantra. Him, reem, hum, hum. It doesn't work. Only pure awareness, discrimination, jnana can lead to mukti. There's no transcendental here. I am who I am, I is awareness, which is straight away takes there. The transcendental meditation, people may practice many years. This is instantaneous. This is the jnana marga or vichara marga which Ramana Maharshi taught. It's called direct path. Straight away, gun point, it straight away goes. It doesn't take time. Transcendental meditation, people practice many years without atma vichara. It doesn't work that way. Transcendental meditation, he'll give a mantra. Om, Hrim, Hrim. All these bija mantras. And each mantra is $1,000. Yeah. Okay. See, that's okay for Westerners, but that's not the marga of Atmadana. Atmadana, you should have a clarity. What is Atma? What is Anatma? What is Nitya? What is Anitya? Straight away go to the point. It doesn't take time. Okay? This concept that meditation will take you to mukti doesn't work. Right? Vichara takes you. Nitya Nitya Viveka takes you. Atma Anatma Viveka takes you. But there's a clarity, not meditation. Please understand, jnana is not a result of meditation. Meditation is a result of jnana. Okay? There are many things go on in the world, let's not comment on that, but let's focus on what is right. So let us sit silently. Become aware of aliveness in your body, I amness. Stay in the heart center. Stay in the feeling of I am-ness. Any thought or feeling or emotion or image comes, go back to I am-ness in the heart center. Be aware of the I am-ness throughout your body. Aliveness. Become aware that you are alive. Become aware of the aliveness in you. Become aware of your body and aliveness in the body.
asato ma sadgamaya tamaso ma jyotirgamaya mrityorma amritam gamaya om shanti shanti shantihi lokaha samstaha sukhino bhavantu lokaha samstaha sukhino bhavantu harihi om shri gurubhyo namaha harihi om.
So this soham, two-step process is clear. I am that, I am. Then I am I. Only? Clear to everybody? So, there are two types of experience in life. How many people want spiritual experience, spiritually? How many people want spiritual experience? Do you have spiritual experience in life?
Which is the other experience? Options.
The worldly experience.
I'm scared to say what experience.
Worldly experience. Huh?
No. Know the options.
People want to know, I had a wonderful spiritual experience, I had a very, very good spiritual experience. Then they say material life, spiritual life and all, right? Pratibha? What is spiritual experience?
Even that is time over.
That is time over. All experiences are spiritual experience only. Only spirit can experience, consciousness only can experience. Okay, eating idli to vada to having a cup of coffee or doing some work, these are all experiences, because only consciousness can understand this. The consciousness is spirit. All experiences belong to the spiritual experience. Okay, people say, no, I saw God, beautiful, colorful. They make it that as a spiritual experience. That's one of the experiences. Every experience is spiritual. There are two types of experience. Okay? General two types of experience. I drink a cup of coffee, it's nice coffee. I drink a cup of tea, nice tea. I smell a flower, nice flower. Okay? There are two types of experience. The experience of something and the experience of nothing. Do you have experience of nothing? Tell me, anybody has an experience of nothing?
Meditation
and deep sleep is experience of nothing. No thing, no means no object. Then what is there? Consciousness is experiencing itself. Okay? Consciousness experiencing itself is called nothing. There's no other thing. The consciousness experiencing itself is called bliss, ananda. No thing means no object. Thing is object, means no thought. So in deep sleep, there is no thought, no body, no world. Then what is there? Consciousness, which is God, experiencing itself. It's called bliss, ananda. Okay? So eating, drinking a cup of coffee, God is experiencing a cup of coffee. That's all. Consciousness only can experience, nothing, nobody else can experience. Even drinking a cup of coffee also is a spiritual experience. In fact, my whole spiritual quest started, is drinking a cup of coffee spiritual? If you look at my old blogs, drinking a cup of coffee, is it spiritual? That is the question I started teaching. When you say experience, who is the experiencer? Consciousness. Consciousness only can experience. How conscious can you say as a knowledge, knowing, awareness? Okay. If there's no awareness, there's no experience. Right?
That's why our shloka says, Brahmarpanam, Brahmahavihi, Brahmagno, Brahmanahutam, Brahmayu tena gantavim, Brahmakarma samadhana. That is not the problem. Okay? Experiencer is the problem. Experience is not a problem. Experience, without experiencer, is called divine experience. Who is the experiencer? The society child. it comes and says, I experienced it. Okay? Society child makes a claim, I experienced it. That is the experiencer. The real experiencer is consciousness. But consciousness is experiencer, experience without an experiencer, because consciousness is an entity. Experience appear and disappear in consciousness. Appear and disappear.
So claimer and interpreter.
That is the society child. Right? Others, all experiences are divine experiences. Drinking a cup of coffee, eating idli, vada, okay, doing puja, taking naivedyam, everything is an offering to God, Brahmarpanam. But somebody comes and claims in between, I am only eating it. That guy is society child. Hey, Madam Ramani, serious about it? No.
Sadhana generally brings you to this Atma Vichara.
Huh.
And sadhanas are different. Somebody does yoga, somebody does pranayama, somebody does japa, somebody does puja. So many things. Somebody does work, his worship, social work.
Right.
Anyway, let us say their Atma Vichara, you held that it is a very simple thing. It's not something, enlightenment is not something great. Anybody at any time can be enlightened.
No. It requires a maturity to come to that.
Okay. Sadhana, you have come to it at the ekkole. Let us, for the moment, think we are all enlightened. Okay.
We are all enlightened.
Okay. Now we go back home. Now again, everybody has got his own. Should I continue my pranayama?
The question is, I didn't say pranayama is not required. I didn't say anything is not required. So pranayama has its own benefit.
It has brought you to a particular
point. Not only that, pranayama has its own benefit. It will keep you good health. Okay. It keeps you, all those things it does. So yoga does something. So now what I am saying is, each has its own benefit and limitation.
You took up particular sadhana thinking that you will go towards the
Atmavichara. Yes, but that's not
the case. Now, whether that practice...
The approach to the practice is different. Correct.
It's different.
The approach to the practice is, what is the utility of the practice?
Correct.
Okay. So now, pranayama, is it required? Yes. If, as long as you say, my health is important, it keeps my health fine. But...
Puja,
it's important. Okay.
I still have to drive the car.
It can be for teaching.
Yeah, food. So many people are in the universe. You are part of the universe.
Let us take the puja.
But these are optional.
Let us take the puja. So I told, every activity can be converted into puja.
Correct.
Right. See, there is a saying. The saying is, puja is, our idea of puja is what I do in the puja room. Actually, puja is what you do after you come out of the puja room. That is the real puja. Because that half an hour, you are learning the attitude of puja, or you are making your mind worshipful. So, puja, your real puja begins once you come out of the puja room. You are doing sadhana time. So, that attitude of worshipfulness, am I able to apply in my life? Our concept of puja is very limited actually. Puja is what I do half an hour in the puja room and close the door. That's not puja. That's the learning of how to be worshipful throughout the day. Right? So now every activity you can convert into puja. So now whether you do that puja or do all the activities puja, it's up to you. Ultimately, am I in full awareness or not? Okay? For bringing for full awareness, I need a puja, do it. Because mind drifts. So you understand the purpose of enlightenment. Enlightenment means separate out the thought from the awareness so that you don't drift. So for that, I need to do puja, do it. I need to do karma yoga, do it. I need to pranayama, do it. But the purpose is not by pranayama I get the awareness. By, with the awareness I do pranayama. With the awareness I do puja.
The whole thing has changed immediately. Before and after that I
have so.
But what I am telling is this practices, some of them you can't, like cooking, eating, drinking, eating, you can't avoid. But other things are options.
No, no. The option only, I'm saying that's only difference in the option. So the option is earlier.
Puja is an option. Japa is an option.
No, no. Japa.
Japa is an option.
No, no. I'm saying japa. Bring with awareness you do japa. Okay. So at a point of time when your awareness is stabilized, you don't need japa. Don't do it. See right now if I understand this awareness will not stay immediately. It takes some time to
seep in.
Till that time when you require, do it. But the concept that by japa I will need mukti is not correct. Right? It's the other way.
And if I don't do something, bad will happen, that is stupid.
That's gone. Okay? The fear will go.
Fear is gone.
Okay? The fear will go. And what is mukti, wrong understanding will go. Whatever I am telling is the highest Vedanti teaching. Mukti is awareness. Aham Brahmasmi. I am awareness. So once you start bringing that I am awareness into everything, everything becomes puja. Then what is important, what is not important, you decide. I'm not saying anything is not important. I'm saying everything you do is awareness. So that sometimes, okay, I am have any awareness. Why should I do it? You don't do it. The key is awareness, attention. The attention is God. Attention is Brahman. Awareness is Brahman. Right?
So attention and awareness are the same?
Awareness is constant everywhere. Attention is is a contracted awareness on a certain area. Other attention is focused awareness in some area.
Attention is a quality of the mind.
Attention is the beginning of the mind. Attention, actually when Ramana Maharshi asks, who are you? He is asking, take the attention back to the source. Attention is the first thing which comes from the source. He is not asking the mind to go back. Mind is thoughts. So he says, where does the thought come from? Ask. Now who is asking? Thought cannot ask. The attention has to shift from the thought to the source of the thought. Attention is precursor to the thought.
In other words, can I say awareness is I, attention is I am?
I am also, there's no attention. I am is just a presence. From I amness, the attention comes. I amness, attention comes. See, for example, your body is alive. That's I amness. Okay, because it's aliveness, attention comes. Now the attention has to go back to the source. Okay?
So first outward pulses.
First outward movement is attention. Then we'll get into next level, we'll get into details why that outward movement takes place. Right? We'll hack the Maya fully.
You are the biggest hacker into everything.
That is why my only job is to hack into Maya.
Hackathon.
Hackathon. Right. So, experience are two types. Experience of an object and experience of a subject. Right? Experience of subject is subject, experience of nothingness. Experience of object is experience of something. Are you clear? There are two types of experience. Now, are both spiritual experience? Only spirit can experience, matter cannot experience. Even drinking a liquor, bottle of liquor is also spiritual experience. Anyway, that's called spiritual experience only. They are wise people. They call it spiritual experience. Spirit. And it's called spiritual, actually it's called spirit, okay? When you drink, the mind will go dull. When the mind is mind is not dull, only body and atma is there. It is a spiritual experience in that sense.
Double spirit.
Double spirit. Okay. Only problem is that the dull mind cannot understand atma, so that's why it will act, goes for another round of spirit. So,
deep sleep.
Deep sleep. Right. So you have to go to spirit with jnana, not with the bottle of liquor. Okay? Right? Jnana. Jnana means Viveka Vairagya.